So historically in the grid, when you connect things at the distribution level in the neighborhoods, the homes, et cetera, many of those devices are just put online and they operate without any coordination. And that makes for challenges in other parts of the grid. And so in this program, we've been able to show to utilities, stakeholders, regulators, et cetera, that we can take all of these devices, successfully coordinate them in a way that provides benefit to the grid.
So every day we hear that there are more and more devices added to the system, such as solar panels, electrical vehicles. People create more and more energy on the edge of the system. These algorithms are able to coordinate all this energy and optimize all these systems in a way, in a concert with the grid, basically, to make sure that the grid is stable and also all the customers are satisfied.
The main challenge pertains to the coordination of a number of assets in a distribution system or even a transmission system in real time. And by real time, I mean at the second or sub-second level.
NREL's Nodes project is one of 12 projects that were funded through this portfolio. And if you look into portfolio of the projects, they probably at this point in time have gone furthest when it comes to demonstration in the field. Not only did they test technology developed in NREL's EC facility, they tested in a microgrid, and they set up in California, and they are testing it also with a Holy Cross co-op.
So this project laid fundamental groundwork for other projects at NREL, and one notable project is autonomous energy systems, where we are talking about even larger systems, multi-cell systems. And you can view what we did in this project as a cornerstone, in a sense that it allows to optimize one single cell in the system, one single area in the system. Now in autonomous energy systems, we are taking this further and we are optimizing a multi-cell system where every cell can use the same distributed algorithm that was developed, but you have the coordination between the cells and therefore you can attain even larger scalability.
So what excites me most about being involved in this project is being able to start at the control and design stage and really come up with new ideas of how to develop something that is very transformational for the grid. And then be able to look at that from the lens of a theoretician. What's the best way to design this algorithm? How can we prove it's going to work? But then be able to move that to implementation.
This work, basically being a cornerstone of this future vision of energy systems where you can add different devices into the system in a way that is easy, plug and play. And it also can support the vision of smart cities and a cleaner energy world where you can use your own energy sources on the edge, optimize them and coordinate them, orchestrate them so that the entire system works well, similarly to how it worked with large power plants, but now with all these different smaller devices that are deployed at people's houses.